Well, Bach has a cosmology. I mean, he gives you that feeling of a rounded, at least he does to me, the universe is rounded and it will come back around, whatever he is, you know? Which is a wonderful feeling, even if it's an illusion. I don't know.
So when we are restless, time is very different from when we are calm. And pieces with restlessness have been created, and with calmness. So in the beginning, you were hesitant to mention a word among scientists, you that literally said, namely the word mysterious, or another word,
mystical.
Now, this, I think, is the main question that has been already touched. How can mystique be created? And Debussy said something nice about music. He said, la musique est une mathématique mystérieuse dont les éléments participent de l'infini. Music is a mysterious mathematics of which the elements take part of infinity. So, where is this mystery or this mystique? I have a tendency to prefer minor.
You're not alone.
So, I'm not a pessimist, so that's not the sadness that attracts me. And then somebody who taught me some music told me, ah, but minor is not about sadness, minor is about complexity.
It took me at least 5 performances of Requiem of a Ray, which is beautiful, before I could say, I need, contrary to maybe some people, I need to kind of understand the music. I need to know what is going to happen, and I cannot analyze as you can, because I do not have the instruments, but if I do not understand, then it never takes me. So whether it's Mozart or Beethoven or Bach, it always takes time. So that's understanding architecture, I think.
Could you compare it with the learning a language?
Most likely, yes.
Yes.
All the variations, a sort of mannerist way of composing music, where there is a tradition, which you mentioned, a strong tradition that it comes out of, as mannerist painting came from the strong movement of Baroque painting, and then, you know, it was also mentioned, you try to push it further. So these are the rules, we all know the rules by now, and how do I start perverting them and see what happened if I pervert it here? The same happened in mannerist architecture, where all these elements appear in places where they shouldn't have been. You take a classical Renaissance palazzo and then you build a topsy-turvy one where nothing is where it should be, which I wonder if there's a comparison, or if you would say it applies to the Goldberg variations, or is that pushing?
The manners thing is fascinating because the piece, the Goldberg variations actually begins, I mean the theme is its own island of beauty. And then it begins very much like a primer, right? Almost. There's nothing there. It's all clear, 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 right? And it's the same. Even here. I'm doing seconds, I'm doing intervals, I'm doing a G. The next variation is just triads, right? More or less, right? And then, as it goes along, the mannerist frenzy takes over. Yeah? And even the one who played right, it's hard to imagine anything more extravagant than that. But then after that comes. sense like the whole structure is oscillating. Like the idea is sort of so, like in the frenzy of invention is so great that the idea can't almost be contained, it feels like.
Mm.
And that seems to me like a progress from humble workman to mannerist, and then only at the end sort of re-enveloping. So that's a long answer to your question.
I think that is important in these discussions not to mix that up too much, at least, and to think that, or to understand that science is also saying something, at least comes to the classical programmatic aim of science, is to speak about things that are outside us. Even or if humans are no longer there, and no life may be in Earth, still there is something to speak about in the sense that there will be an objective reality. And that is what we are trying to understand in the science. In music or in art in general, it's much more often a way of dealing with that reality, trying to translate or maybe about human relations or sentiments and things like that, which are not always recognized by all of our cultures. Indeed, as was mentioned, we have to learn to appreciate music. We are in a family, we are in a community, we are on a continent, and we are learning that music. We believe that science, and in particular mathematics, is universal. You can teach it in China, you can teach it in Ireland, you can teach it in Canada, in the same way, the same language.
Mathematics is not a science. So science is about the world out there, and mathematics is about the world in here.
No, I don't understand. I don't believe it.
Mathematics is about concepts.
Well, I mean, physics is also about concepts.
Yes.
I mean, I don't like this Platonic idea, but we disagree, of course, on that. But
you're distinguishing mathematics from the natural science.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mathematics, in principle, has nothing to do with the world. And then some structures are invented that happen to fit on the world. So, because you open your eyes. Mathematicians don't need to open their eyes, but they need to open their mind.
I recently joined music, and all I hear about it is like it's math, it's maybe a language, it's a function, like you described, like you analyzed it, it's a sequence, etc. And if you tell this to an IT guy about math, functions, language, well, he's going to tell you, I can program it. Mm-hmm. Do you think a computer will be able to maybe, and I'm not trying to provoke too much, like to achieve the same level of Bach?
Well, they're trying, right?
So I'm just saying, like, the amount of parameters that we sort of feel music and live music is so much more complex than any kind of set of parameters that I'm not afraid, you know, you can't calculate it, you know, it's very human.